his angels. The angels call human beings an ambitious and merciless creature and protested against his creation. But the Almighty responded, quote, "I have knowledge of what you are ignorant of," unquote. Then the Almighty taught Adam the truth, and on the order of the Almighty, Adam revealed it to the angels. The angels could not understand the truth as revealed by the human being. The Almighty said to them, quote, "Did not I say that I am aware of what is hidden in heaven and in the universe?" Unquote. In this way, the angels prostrated themselves before Adam. In the mission of all divine prophets, the first sermons were of the words of God, and those words, piety, faith, and wisdom, have been spread to all mankind. Regarding the holy prophet Moses, may peace be upon him, God says, quote, "And he was taught wisdom, the divine book, the Old Testament, and the New Testament. He is the prophet appointed for the sake of the children of Israel, and I rightfully brought a sign from the Almighty." Holy Quran, Al-Umran Surah, unquote. The first words which were revealed to the Holy Prophet of Islam called the Prophet to read, quote, "Read, read in the name of your God who supersedes everything," unquote. The Almighty, quote again, "who taught the human being with the pen," unquote. Quote, "The Almighty taught human beings what they were ignorant of," unquote. You see, in the first verses revealed to the Holy Prophet of Islam, words of reading, teaching, and the pen are mentioned. These verses, in fact, introduce the Almighty as the teacher of human beings, the teacher who taught humans what they were ignorant of. In another part of the Quran, on the mission of the Holy Prophet of Islam, it is mentioned that the Almighty appointed someone from amongst the common people as their prophet in order to, quote, "read for them the divine verses," unquote, and quote again, "and purify them from ideological and ethical contaminations," unquote, and quote again, "to teach them the divine book and wisdom," unquote. My dear friends, all the words and messages of the divine prophets, from Abraham and Isaac and Jacob to David and Suleiman and Moses to Jesus and Muhammad, delivered humans from ignorance, negligence, superstitions, unethical behavior, and corrupted ways of thinking with respect to knowledge, on the path to knowledge, light, and rightful ethics. In our culture, the word science has been defined as illumination. In fact, the science means brightness, and the real science is the science which rescues the human being from ignorance to his own benefit. In one of the widely accepted definitions of science, it is stated that it is the light which sheds to the hearts of those who have been selected by the Almighty. Therefore, according to this definition, science is a divine gift, and the heart is where it resides. If we accept that science means illumination, then its scope supersedes the experimental sciences, and it includes every hidden and disclosed reality. One of the main harms inflicted against science is to limit it to experimental and physical sciences. This harm occurs even though it extends far beyond this scope. Realities of the world are not limited to physical realities, and the material is just a shadow of supreme realities. And physical creation is just one of the stories of the creation of the world. Human being is just an example of the creation that is a combination of a material and the spirit. And another important point is the relationship of science and purity of spirit, life, behavior, and ethics of the human being. In the teachings of the divine prophets, one reality shall always be attached to science, the reality of purity of spirit and good behavior. Knowledge and wisdom is pure and clear reality. It is science is a light, it is a discovery of reality, and only a pure scholar and researcher, free from wrong ideologies, superstitions, selfishness, and material trappings, can discover discover the reality. My dear friends and scholars, distinguished participants, science and wisdom can also be misused, a misuse caused by selfishness, corruption, material desires, and material interests, as well as individual and group interests. Material desires place humans against the realities of the world. Corrupted, independent human beings resist acceptance of reality. And even if they do accept it, they do not obey it. There are many scholars who are aware of the realities but do not accept them. Their selfishness does not allow them to accept those realities. Did those who, in the course of human history, wage wars, not understand the reality that lives, properties, dignity, territories, and the rights of all human beings should be respected? Or did they understand it, but neither have faith in nor abide by it? My dear friends, as long as the human heart is not free from hatred, envy, and selfishness, it does not abide by the truth, by the illumination of science and science itself. Science is the light, and scientists must be pure and pious. If humanity achieves the highest level of